spirit is at last. Oh, thanks so much.
So, you finished the job. Well done. Thank you for that, my dear friend. One, two, three! Lovely.
I want to go loads of places too and meet the people. Are you one of those adventurers?
That Saker always seems to get away with it.
If you would like to have me as a true friend, then do me a little favour. I'd be very grateful if you were to pick something up and bring it to me. Wonderful. I shall await the delivery of said item with gleeful anticipation. But the most interesting thing has to be a rather odd object. It has some historical value.
Please help us. There's no food.
None at all. It's like a never-ending nightmare. This is bad. This is so bad.
Ooh. We will not be undersold. That is our non-binding guarantee.
We don't need more.
I have no doubt that the people of Brightwall will end up following you. Merely show them what you are capable of, and they cannot fail to become your supporters. Dare I say, you're not likely to get much further without more people following you. Perhaps you should complete some additional quests.
Let me buy your unwanted items. Fair price paid.
What was their name?
Huh?
Ooh.
Yes, yes.
I'm sure this will be ever so present for you, because I like you so much.
And, I'll buy your stuff.
You, good sir, you who live in such a tumultuous epoch, do you not thirst for the drama and emotion of a properly structured tragic play?
Of course you don't.
You want to escape your troubles. You want to be made merry. You want to be amused.
It is no good. We shall never agree.
Ah, if only we could get our hands on Morley's lost play. It would solve all our problems.
Yes, it is said to bring together the opposites of tragedy and comedy in an exquisite marriage of forms.
But perhaps you can find it.
Yes, we beg you. The theatre, the muses, the very heart and soul of this town will thank you. Splendid, splendid. You should know we did commission an elderly detective to search the library for clues as to the play's whereabouts, but he never returned.
The man's name is Ransom Locke, and he's rather closer to senility than one would like, truth be told.
If you come across this gentleman, he may be able to aid you. I believe he is looking for the collected works of the playwright Philip Thmorley as we speak.
One can only hope they were not burned when the king closed down the academy and its library.
Turn back now, mortal one. Stay away from this accursed
only
place.
Death
and insanity await you. Thou seekest forbidden knowledge, but shall find naught but damnation. Don't pick it up. No, really, I'm serious. Just can't leave well enough alone, can you? Bloody literary tourist, bane of my afterlife. Listen, you. You're not getting my lost play. You hear? It's rubbish. Worse than rubbish. I mean, what was I thinking mixing tragedy and comedy? I must have been off my rocker.
It would seem, my dear fellow, you have been apprehended by the ghost of Philip Morley. That makes us both his captives. I am Ransom Locke. If the name seems familiar, it is because I was once a detective of some renown. And yet, here I am, ready to live out the rest of my days, trapped in a book. As far as I can deduce, we are currently in a scene from one of Morley's greatest romantic plays, the near tragedy of Oliver and Ethel. I believe if we are to escape, we must act out the scene. But performing is not one of my talents. If I am correct, putting on this costume should set things in motion.
Oh, Ethel, my love, my life, my son. If thou wouldst but give me one sign, one gesture that would speak of your affections, then might I think this grey existence worth living.
Ah, yes, a classic moment in the play. You are Ethel, the beautiful young daughter of a dung merchant. Show Oliver that you love him, and we may be able to leave this scene.
My heart is yours, my love.
Let the heavens and the seas, the toads and the eels sing the song in my heart, for she doth love me, and all is well. We shall meet again in the morrow, my little ferret, and elope into the sunset to live out our days in wondrous joy.
A magnificent rendition. Truly, I applaud you.
I see you are gifted with remarkable literary cunning, but can you really comprehend the depths of my work? That we shall see.
Ah, yes. This is undoubtedly a scene from one of Morley's earlier, funnier plays, Bloodbath at the Royal Court. And this must be your costume. The role of the fool is one filled with tragic death. It will require a masterful performance.
What fresh insolence is this? Out of my throne, you impertinent buffoon! Stand before your king, and do your jester's duty. 'Tis a troublesome time for this court, and my crown grows heavy. So make me laugh, or I shall have your head.
Goochie-goochie-goo!
Oh, stop! It's too funny! I believe I'm in the right mood now to meet with those foreign delegates. I think I shall only behead half of them. Yes.
I have never seen a more convincing fool. There is hope for us yet.
You handle my royal dramas as well as you handle my romances. But will your versatility extend to the more subtle domains of theatre, I wonder?
Oh, dear. Unless I'm mistaken, this is a scene from Morley's notoriously violent historical epic, Titus the Mutilator, Part 2. Which would mean this is the gladiatorial arena from Act 5, where Titus is finally slaughtered by savage warriors seeking revenge. A favorite scene of mine as a child, I must admit. And here is Titus's famous costume. I had some pajamas that looked just like it. Put it on and you will take on the greatest role of your life.
Titus, thy pox-membered body shall pay for thy monstrous villainy. My son lies dead because of you. Now shall revenge be mine, cold as your corpse and all the more flavoursome for it.
Do try to make your demise convincing.
Bloody beggar, aren't you, boy? What are you doing fighting the likes of us? That didn't look too bad, mate. Come on! He's not so big. Don't let him push you around like that.
Yeah, make him bleed. Not my new shirt.
Maybe I should get out of here! Hey! You!
More of my kin lie slain, and
and yet you live! You have breathed your last sulfur-scented breath, Titus! Show them how we mercenaries fight. I've never seen combat skills like that. That shooting will kill you, you know. All my men dead. My vengeance denied, my world undone! I cannot stand to live one second more!
A tremendous performance. That's just the ending I wanted to see when I was a young boy attending the theatre every weekend. I wonder what scene will follow now.
Oh, what scene could possibly follow such a masterful rendition of my work? The way you improvised some of those roles, you brought new life to my words. I stand in awe. You have earned the prize no mortal has ever been honored with before. My missing play. I entrust it to you, for I know that you will do it justice. I call it the Ham Sandwich. A metaphorical title, of course.
Ah, you have retrieved our aged investigator. Happy day! Have you perchance found...
This is no time for perchances, Lambert. The play! Do you have it? We're saved, Lambert!
Oh, the joy in my bosom knows no bounds! Thank you a million times! Thank you!
His head bosom. It's already working. Comedy and tragedy will at last join hands.
Hark. Bear witness to the tragic futility that is man. Oh, how it doth sear my senses to see paradise and yet to be barred.
That reminds me of a great joke. A guard, a monk, and a chicken walk into a bar. Unfortunately, the bartender had had a mild heart attack that morning, so none of them get served.
And yet, what purpose doth heartache serve when the infinite dark blanket that is death falls softly upon our still beating corpse?
That reminds me of another one. A corpse walks into a bar and says, "Can I have a lemonade?" "Certainly," replies the bartender. "I've never seen a stiff drink."
And so endeth our happy, sad play, which reminds us we are made of nothing but clay. There's time only for our fool to say...
Great big giant bosoms!
What the hell was that?
Biggest load of old tosh I ever saw. It didn't even make sense.
Worst play ever.
Well done. You have gathered quite an impressive following in Brightwall. This should be more than enough to convince this little hamlet to send aid to the dwellers. I believe Samuel awaits you at the town gate to express that very sentiment.
I'm beginning to understand why Philip Morley never published this particular piece of work in his lifetime.
Indeed, it is too far ahead of its time. Perchance one day a civilization will rise with the broadness of brain to truly appreciate it.
If you ask me, it was the tragic elements that let it down. One cannot argue with the comedy.
Oh, a pox on you, Pinch!
If you'll only give a little,
I'll stop bothering you.
Esteemed citizens of Brightwall, today we demonstrate the generous nature of our fair town. For too long have our mountain neighbors suffered in silence, and now we extend a helping hand. But this effort would not have been possible without the courage and determination of one man, the son of the old hero king. From this day, we shall know you as the Hero of Brightwall. Before you leave, we ask of you one favor. As we pledge ourselves to you, so we hope you will pledge to return Brightwall to its former glory and reopen the academy which your father founded.
I will.
Very, very good, very good. I expected nothing less from you. These volunteers shall carry the supplies to the dweller camp. They may have them with our blessing. I hope you will return one day, not just as our hero, but as our king!
You're sure to find something
special? Let me buy your unwanted items. Fair price, please. That's a welcome change. The day I'm having.
Upon that wall, you'll find the contracts representing the promises that you've made to the people of Albion. Your contract with Samuel is there, for example. Anyone can make a promise, but then what do you do about it? You have done a wonderful thing for those poor people in the mountains. They will be overjoyed when you arrive with the aid that you acquired for them.
Our hero returns, bringing good tidings and supper.
Damn thing doesn't open. How do you... Oh, well, I never thought you'd actually get it, tell you the truth. Boulder.
We've been blessed, my friends. We have made an alliance that has already brought us life. One day, it will bring us much more. We require but one more offering before we fight at your side.
Balder.
Promise to restore these mountains to their full glory and to protect our right to dwell in them, and promise you will bring nothing but the fiercest justice upon Logan's head.
I promise.
Then may we be carried into the castle by the dark storms of fury.
We'll have to wait a little longer for that. It's still just us against a whole army. We need to recruit more people.
I was afraid you'd come over all logical and sensible.
Well, you have brought us a feast, and we are free to hunt again. We'll just keep on eating and drinking till you're good and ready. Right, Balder?
He couldn't be happier.
You have made an important ally today. The revolution cannot hope to succeed without fighters such as Sabine and his people on your side. You have the beginnings of an army now.
Typical thing for a tyrant to do, if you ask me. Put an end to the people learning.
I couldn't be prouder of what you've accomplished here. But there is still much for us to do. And I know just where to find our next allies. I'll meet you at the station in Mistpeak when you're ready. The revolution is just getting started.
But the most interesting thing has to be a rather odd object I'm convinced must have some historical value. I'm sure my cousin Saul would know what it is. He works over at the Brightwall Academy, you see. Very bright fellow. You wouldn't mind taking it to him, would you? I'd do it myself, but all that digging has done my back in. Wonderful. How kind you are. Here it is.
I placed the contract representing your promise to Sabine on the wall.
Got too much gear? Sell it to me!
Thanks for coming in. Fill up your belly with our foodstuffs.
Steel weapons are a thing of the past.
Thank you. So nice to hold it once more in my hands. That seals it then. We're going to be the best of friends, you and I.
Closing time for shops.
Nancy, your round.
Oh, thank you. From my cousin, is it? She's always sending me odd things she finds around the house. Although this one does look quite intriguing. I shall have a closer look when I have the time.
My dear Saul, you're an odd fish and no mistake. Possibly a trout, or maybe even weirder, like a sea cucumber or something. Though technically they aren't fish. Anyway, you look like some kind of mutant fish thing. So there, yours sincerely, Arthur.
A little something new has appeared in... Ah, hello.
So I'll offer you more if you've got one.
Well, hello there. I could use your help, you know, cleaning up the streets. I'm ashamed to admit it, but we've had a rash of jailbreaks, and not enough men on duty to track the criminals down. If you could help us out, I'd pay you for your time. Just find them and drag them back here. No doubt they'll put up a fuss, but you can handle it, I'm sure. That's great. With your help, we'll get the criminal scum off our streets once and for all.
I give hard cash for your unwanted goods, on the spot.
I've got a present for you, because I like you so much. Everyone needs a friend like you.
Take me in hand, then. See you later, then. Did you know there's a small sale on?
Ah, are you ready to go?
It's late and I'm off to bed.
If that's what you want.
What did you have to do to be the hero of Brightwall? Did you have to do lots of homework? How are you? You're the nicest person around here.
Off somewhere exciting, then. Here's a present for you, friend.
I hope you're not looking to cause trouble.
Yes. Let's go somewhere good.
You're not going to take me alive, copper.
Oh, all right then, just this once.
Don't see.
Okay. I might as well tag along.
Does make
I like
smile.
Playing with
Do you like cheese? I love a bit of cheese, me. Cheesy, cheesy, cheese.
Then let's change the subject, shall we?
Heard any interesting
Delivery.
Things lately?
Did you see that long-lost
Never let me go. What are you doing this for, anyway? Did they put a bounty on me head? I can offer you more.
Ah, it's the recidivist. Virtually born in jail he was. Always breaking out, always coming back. Fine job, thank you. I'll let you know if we need your help again.
Now, I'm good with faces, and I'm quite sure I don't remember yours.